This is the VOA Special English Technology Report. Last week, we told you about the Imagine Cup Finals in the United States. Team Flash Food from Arizona State University won top honors at the Microsoft event. The team developed a mobile application and website to help restaurants, hotels, and farmers markets donate food to people who need it. The businesses enter information about the food they would like to donate. A notification goes to a team of volunteer drivers who can go pick up the leftover food and take it to people in need. This is perishable food, the kind of food that cannot normally be handled by food banks or other food recovery organizations. The Flash Food Project grew out of the engineering projects in community service program at Arizona State. The director of that program, Richard Philly, says the project has far-reaching possibilities. Mr. Philly plans to work with the team to find ways to extend the Flash Food app to other countries. In his words, would those cultures in those different countries be open to the idea of taking leftover food and using Flash Food to connect with people who are hungry? We don't know the answer to that yet, says Mr. Philly. The Imagine Cup is now in its 10th year. Mark Hinsbaugh is a vice president with Microsoft. He says students who enter the competition can now build their ideas around a lot of technology that was not widely available 10 years ago. In the beginning, he says, people were building almost everything from scratch. But now, he points to the Flash Food app as a good example of bringing together existing technologies. The students built the app on the assumption that there are smartphones in the hands of most of the people they need to work with. Also, the use of mapping software lets the app give the volunteer drivers turn-by-turn directions to the restaurants with food to donate. Team Flash Food will represent the United States at the Imagine Cup World Finals in Australia in July. Mark Hinsbaugh says solving world problems like hunger is a major goal of the competition. But another major goal is to get more American students interested in jobs in science and engineering. When you look at the pipeline in science, technology, engineering, and math, we come up way short, he says. As a result, he says around 1 million software and tech jobs could go unfilled in the United States over the next 5 years. For VOA Special English, I'm Carolyn Prasuti.